Well, good evening. We are very, very happy to be back here again in scenic, historic, cultural, depressive, and anal retentive Woodstock, New York. And in an oasis of politically progressive people in the murky conservative backwaters of Ulster County. You see, in Woodstock, we don't have deer ticks. We have companion animals. We don't have Republicans. We have companion vegetables. In Woodstock, I am not male, I am biologically incorrect. My buddy Gilles over here is not schizophrenic, he's doubly able. Now, you know, I've said many times that if you stand on the village green in Woodstock and you throw a brick straight up into the air, your chances are 1 in 3 of hitting an alternative therapist. Now, it could be a Seventh-day acupuncturist. It could be a practitioner of post-mortem massage therapy, which is where they keep the corpse relaxed and centered during the process of rotting, which in Woodstock they refer to as aromatic transformation. But that said, some of us, many of us in this country, cannot afford the wonderful services of these incredible healers, because most of us in this country still lack for affordable health care. Mm-hmm. And you know, when you're dealing with issues of social justice, it's all connected, okay? So the lack of affordable health care is directly connected to police oppression in the black communities, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So we've got a little tune about the health care. We've been singing this for years, and we'd love to stop singing it, but nothing has changed. So we've taken an old jazz and blues tune from the 1930s, and that's the basis for this. I went down to the St. James Wellness Facility. See if my baby could be cured. She was laid out cold on a gurney. So sad, so sweet, so uninsured. Let her go, let her go, can't afford it. My $10,000 deductible ain't been paid. You know the fact that you gotta be one of the Koch brothers to afford good health care. Cuts deeper and colder than a surgeon blade. Today, let's see, I can choose between a proctologist in Botswana or an orthopedic surgeon in Paraguay. Yes, I checked in with some serious palpitations. Doctor said my arteries getting hard. Well, then he did some laptop computation. Said I can save you if you got Visa or MasterCard. When I die, I want you to bury me under the bed of the head of the AMA. You better pin an IOU to my tombstone. Cause we ain't got universal healthcare in the USA. Yeah. I want 6 cardiovascular associates to carry my coffin. 6 immunologists to heave a sigh. I want 6 oncologists watching from the golf course.
Oh yeah.
And 6 hematologists bleed me dry. I want 6 undertakers and 6 underwriters for Edna. As you roll out that repo Cadillac, there'll be 30 malpractice lawyers going down to the burying ground. A billion unpaid bills fluttering back. Oh, let it go, let it go, can't afford it. My $10,000 deductible ain't been paid. know I'd rather be fracking the ice in Dante's Inferno than be a sickly person of low to moderate income. In USA. Preaching to the choir. And my response to that is always, well, yeah, it's true, but you know what? It's so much less stressful. We were billed on the flyer tonight as comics. We usually are. We're often comic, but we also feel we're allowed to get serious from time to time. So we're going to do a serious tune. We're going to have our friend Pamela Pentany join us here. So please give her a hand. It's based on an old protest song, believe it or not, about the oppression of Welsh miners. And you knew it in the 60s as the Bells of Rhymney. But our version is about the abuse of police authority, and it's called The Cops of L.A. Gone away, and we'd really like to have her back one of these days. So Just a little tune about that.
Oh, Miss Liberty, she's up and left us. Her pedestal, now it is bare. She used to stand tall in the harbor, but now she's gone, Allah knows where. Well, I wrote her a letter last Black Day. I told her how much she's been missed. Well, I got a reply on the 4th of July, and what she said to me was this.
Oh, when vegans eat sushi on pizza, and the tea party switches to wine. When a team of remarkable surgeons gives Democrat leaders a spine. When the Lakers make Tom Cruise their center. And your lunch and my lunch are free. And when Yahweh above blesses transgender love, then maybe I'll come back to thee.
Oh, when senators work for a living. Walmarts are all unionized. And that horrible jail down in Cuba are only detaining the flies. When the ozone is patched up with duct tape and Rupert starts printing what's true.
When everything's cool and we're
out of Kabul, then maybe I'll come back to you. Oh, when every religious fanatic as snot on a rock is reborn.
And slim little poetry chapbooks do twice as much business as four.
When the Cubs find themselves in the series and win with a roster that's gay.
On a SWAT team of greens cleans up New Orleans, then maybe I'll come back to stay. One more time.
Oh, and the White House is housing the homeless, and the lawns all turn out to be duds.
When Limbaugh is smitten with lockjaw, and the Crips have a bake sale for blood.
An Orthodox Jewish Latina is the darling of the GOP.
And when Donald says, Ted, hey man, let's go to bed,
then maybe I'll come back. We'll see.
Scream by Wall Street, living on the streets of Greek. there will be an answer.
Let it be Bernie.
And though they often vote against their own best interests, let them see. There will be an answer.
Let it be Bernie. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be.
No corporate lackey,
let it be Bernie.
Yeah. All right. Now this guy's bowed out, but we like this verse, so we'll keep it a minute.
Trump and Cruz would both abuse the Bill of Rights protecting me. Let them stoop each other.
Let it be Bernie.
If you won't take my word, take the word of a celebrity. Spike Lee back in Bernie.
Let it be Bernie.
One more time. Let it